Next, we'd also like to hear from Dr. Thomas, who was also at our initiative last year, and he will give us the inauguration address.
Can I have my presentation, please? So good afternoon to you, and once again, thank you to the organizers for giving me this opportunity. My theme today is that together we can do a lot of things. As all of you know, the medical, the health sector is quite fragmented. And because we are fragmented, we really haven't been able to make, may not be true, till a few years ago, we were not really have been able to make much of progress with the government and other agencies. So I'll just give you a brief report. I represent AHPI and CAHO, Associate of Healthcare Providers of India, and the Consortium of Accredited Hospitals, and I'll just give you a little bit of a peek into what we've been doing and what we've been able to achieve in a small way. Can I have my presentation, please? So as I said, I wear many hats. I was with the Baptist Hospital, retired from there, worked with the World Bank, AHPI, UNBI, and a few other. A little bit about AHPI. I think in the last 3 years, AHPI has tried to reach out into the entire country, getting all the stakeholders involved. We are a not-for-profit organization. We have over 10,000 hospitals all over the country. We have about 15 state chapter branches, and our vision. Vision is very, I come from a mission background, and so do my colleague founders, Devi Shetty, Dr. Giridhar Gyani, Prem Nair. Our vision is a healthy India, society, community, and the common man, because India is made up of the common man. And our mission is to work with stakeholders, like all of you here, to establish a national system where all have universal access to affordable, quality healthcare. As I mentioned, these are our members. We work with quite a large number of hospitals all over the country. Now, quickly, since I have only 10 minutes, and I request you to remind me at 8 minutes so I don't overshoot, what have we done? I think one of the biggest achievements that AHPI has been responsible for, AHPI and CAHO, is to facilitate the entry-level introduction by NABH. All of us sitting in this room know about NABH. We know about the gold standard. But do we know that out of the estimated 80,000 hospitals in the country, there are only about 400 or so hospitals which have got gold standard accreditation? I'm right, 400, no? 400 hospitals, which is a minuscule percentage. And will it help the country? Yes, it will. But people who go to these hospitals, these are mainly big hospitals in cities, they have many other options. So yes, it is something which we can be proud of, that we have introduced to healthcare, the quality in healthcare in India, but is it enough? I'm not convinced. So because of this, AHPI, CAHO, we started a movement saying that there has to be something for the smaller hospitals. After all, 70 to 80% of the beds in the country are in hospitals which have 30 to 50 beds. So if they are not included, then there is really not very much point in having this NABH accreditation. So I happen to be on the board of NABH also, with Dr. Gyani, myself, and a few others. We facilitated the introduction of entry-level standards, entry-level certification. This is about 30% of the original gold standard NABH. And it focuses mainly on patient safety. It's not expensive, because most hospitals are frightened of the expense. Most smaller hospitals are in awe of NABH, saying that's something we can never achieve. So with entry level, we have 30%. It's focused on patient safety. Now, having the standards there is really, by itself, not much of a benefit. So AHPI and CAHO, we went on a mission, because we are passionate about quality going to the common man. We went to various state governments. I'm happy to state that my own government in Karnataka has encouraged entry level. If you do not have entry level accreditation, you get -2%, and in the next year onwards it is mandatory. But I think the most important thing that we have done this year is that we have been able to lobby with IRDA. And they have made it mandatory that in 2 years, from July of this year, any hospital empaneling for IRDA will have to have entry-level accreditation. And that is something huge, because as of today, 33,000 hospitals in the country are empaneled with IRDA. So you're talking about quality at the grassroots. And this is something that HPI is very proud of. We also help other hospitals, HPI hospitals, to comply with the standards established by NABH. When you talk about NABH accreditation, immediately to your mind comes a picture of you have to hire a consultant, you have to pay him a whopping amount, you have to spend a lot on infrastructure. So the concept of entry level was, it is for the smaller hospitals. NABH was very positive. They subsidized the inspection fees for NABH. It was only 10,000. Then we worked, some of my team members are here, we worked on a World Bank guidance manual to help SHCOs achieve entry level. This is available on the website, available for everybody to access. HPI and CAHO worked with the government of Karnataka. We got two government hospitals, purely voluntary, two government hospitals accredited. We worked through innovative courses through the Health Sector Skill Council. Another major area that HPI and CAHO work is in communication. Healthcare communication in India is neglected and very important. Most of the medical legal cases are because of inadequate communication. And we've been able to start a nationwide movement of health communication, trained about 300 trainers who go into the hospitals and other areas, training doctors, nurses, and others. We've written the first healthcare communication book in the country, which has been a bestseller. The second edition has just been bought out. We've gone further because we were not able to cope with the request for the training workshops. We've now evolved an e-learning module. This e-learning module is endorsed by NABH, National Board, Government of Karnataka, Indian Nursing Council, etc. And very importantly, NABH has now incorporated communication as a standard in the fourth edition. We've also worked with the PCPNDT Act. I think two very important players are not here, FOXI and IRIA. In fact, I just came from a meeting from Delhi. All of us know that the PCPNDT Act is a draconian act. It doesn't allow ultrasound to be available to the common man. It harasses doctors. But here again, because we are united, the government is listening to us. So also, the National Steering Committee on Capping, you've been hearing about compensation going into crores. And whom does it finally impact? The patient has to pay for it. So we have a national committee on this. The government has in principle agreed that they would limit the amount of compensation to 55 lakhs for negligence leading to death. And as a result of EHPI and IMA working together with the other stakeholders, two interministerial committees, for the first time in the history of the country, there are two interministerial committees looking into both these. We worked with ESIS, with CGHS, getting our member hospitals' dues. We're looking at them, trying to improve the rates. Another important area that which I think is very significant is we worked with nurses. Most of us in the medical profession really don't give our nurses our due. They are very intelligent, very dedicated. And we've been trying for the last 3 years to get the Ministry of Health to approve nurse practitioner courses. Many of my colleagues in the medical fraternity were against it, but we persevered. Devi Shetty was me in this. And finally, the Ministry of Health has agreed to start the nurse practitioner course from this year. We work closely with ANBAI. And the National Board is now starting courses in all the district hospitals. Karnataka has kicked off that. We actually, I'm also involved with ANBAI, and we were being given stepmotherly treatment by MCI. We were able to talk to them, get the Ministry of Health to say that National Board and MCI degrees are equal. We've been able to impact our hospitals in Karnataka by getting the government of Karnataka to reduce the electricity rates. We have a special rate for hospitals. Similarly, I think in Gujarat and Rajasthan, HPI has been able to do the similar things. We've started a movement called Save the Doctor Movement. In our country, there are about 12,000 clinical postgraduate seats as opposed to 55,000 undergraduate seats. Result is that for 3 years, a doctor sits at home, studies. We have been talking to the union government, and in our last meeting, we are part of a union government health ministry committee, and they have promised to start increasing the amount of postgraduate seats. They've told us that they will try and do it this year, that they will try and increase the seats by about 20 to 40,000. One of the first things we did at, and I'll keep that for last, first things we did as AHPI informally was that the previous government had proposed, passed in parliament a service tax that would be applicable to hospitals, but we were able to get that reversed. So just a brief update that we need to be together. Together we can do a lot of things. We need to be together because ultimately the beneficiary of this would be the common man. Thank you very much.